more like a local rather than just visiting very famous tourist spots, because I think it would make your travel more interesting. So let's get started. The first thing I like to recommend is to visit a jetty in Yangon. There are a couple of jetties, namely Pazundaung Jetty, Wizzar Jetty, and Wadden Jetty. I like to recommend visiting Wadden Jetty because it's more convenient to visit there from downtown of Yangon. And why I recommend visiting a jetty is that because you can learn more about real lives of the real people in Yangon. And there are boats, and there is Yangon River, which is very cool just to look at it, especially during the sunset. So I recommend you to visit there in the evening. There are people who are working for their survival, and I think it's what makes the jetty more appealing. The best part about it is that it's not displaying for the sake of tourists. You know, it's not a tourist spot, so they're working for themselves and their life, and you're just witnessing it as a very interesting place. It's not a special tourist site, so you can learn more about how people walk, how people behave, and you know, things like that. So I definitely recommend to check that place out, because it would make your evening a lot more interesting rather than just spending your time in downtown of Yangon normally. So the second thing I like to recommend is trying an alternative mode of transportation. Of course, taxis in Yangon are very cheap. I hope if you are not cheated, I think it's a lot cheaper comparing to other countries in Southeast Asia. I think it's 10 times cheaper than in Singapore. So it's very convenient to roam around Yangon by taxi. But sometimes it makes the traveling a bit boring. So if you like to learn more about the other transportation mode, I like to recommend visiting by local bus or a truck show. For the local bus part, it's a bit tricky because you have to make sure it's not very crowded, because it's very tiring to take a local bus which is crowded, especially in peak hours. So I recommend you to take your bags between 10 in the morning and before 3 in the evening. It's not a peak hour and the buses could be not very crowded. And you can just take a few stops, you know, you don't need to take your whole trip. You can just take like 3 or 4 stops and just see how the bus conductors are managing people, and how you get into the bed, how you get off your bed, and how people pay money, because we don't have ticketing system, or we don't have tickets at all. We just pay money. But if, I think it would be interesting if you, especially if you have never experienced before, you can just go to a bus stop, get into any bus stop that you see, then drop off at like 3 or 4 stops, so that I hope you won't get lost. And another interesting way is taking a trishaw, because trishaw in Myanmar is different from other Southeast Asian countries. I put an article link in the comment box talking about different trishaws in different Southeast Asian countries. And trishaws in Myanmar are different from all those trishaws. And it's a bit interesting, and it's, you know, there's no roof, and yeah, at the same time, you can a trishaw can host 2 people, so you can travel together with your friend, or if you are a group of people, you can even rent several trishaws together and just visit. And I think it would be fun to take a trishaw in Yangon, especially when the road, of course, you don't go to a very big road in downtown. I think the trishaws are not allowed to ride there, but yeah, you can go to a smaller road and enjoy the atmosphere and trishaw, and you can take photos and people will be staring at you sometimes. So the third thing I'm going to recommend is a bit strange. I think not every local would recommend you to do this, and not every tourist would do this in Yangon, but it is a very worth experience, so I think you should definitely check that out. It's shampooing at a local salon, a neighborhood salon, because it's very, the first thing, it's very cheap. It's about, I think it could be as low as $1.5 US to about $4 or $5, but you need to pay about $20 to wash your hair in Singapore, so I think it's very cheap. And they they give a very thorough massage to your scalp, and it's a very soothing experience. And whenever I visit to Yangon, I go to a local salon nearby my house and just feel the massage and the scalp, and it's very relaxing. And the best thing is worth it. And as a foreigner, you can have a chat with whoever in the salon, and they will be glad to chat with you, and you can learn more about, you know, life of the people and mingle with them, and it's worth it. The number 4 thing is the trickiest, because you may or may not achieve this even if you wanted to try it out, because I like to recommend visiting a high school in Yangon. I recommend this because it's the high schools in Myanmar are very different from high schools in other countries. There are almost no facilities, and you know that even the chairs, the blackboard, it's very laid back and traditional, and the uniforms are also interesting. I mean, the public school, of course, private schools would be more similar to international schools in other countries, but public schools are very interesting, and it's very hard to get in, especially for foreigners, I think. But if you have a friend who is working in high school, or whose friends are working there, you can ask them or request them to introduce with you whoever has the authority to allow you into the school. And if you get into it, I think it will be very fun experience that you have never experienced before, and you can get a glimpse about the education in Myanmar just by visiting there. The fifth thing I like to recommend you is visiting a smaller pagoda. Of course, everyone would love to rush to Shwedagon Pagoda whenever they reach to Myanmar, especially if it's their first visit. I mean, who wouldn't? But sometimes when it gets very crowded and everyone takes rushing to take photo and things like that, you might want to visit smaller pagoda as an alternative, because there would be less tourists, and there could be a monastery in the compound of the pagoda. So it's like throwing two birds at one stone, and you can visit a pagoda, you can visit a monastery, and you can even talk to a man who could be learning English, and it's sometimes very interesting to learn things about Myanmar or anything like that from their perspective. And not only in famous pagoda like Shwedagon Pagoda, but also in smaller pagodas, you can have very interesting sculptures and paintings and things like that. The best part is you could have more time studying it or taking photos or doing anything you like, because there are less people. So that's about it for this episode, and I hope you would find this useful, and I really hope that you could try at least one or two things in this list whenever you happen to visit Myanmar. And if you like to know anything about Myanmar, or you know anything that you are very keen to know, feel free to comment down below, and I'll try to address in next videos. Ta-da!